Hello there, all you amazing people. We are going to make, or I'm going to make a brief video, I hope, about is macOS UNIX. And it's not. It's UNIX certified. And I think you can pay your way into that to some degree. But the UNIX name is owned by this group, the group here, the Open Group. They handle the UNIX certification, the UNIX trademark, standards, what you will call it. I think, if I'm not mistaken, they also handle the POSIX certification X, Y, and Z. They are basically the ones that tells you what you are and what you are not when it comes to UNIX, apparently. The register of UNIX certification products. So they have like here, the Open Group official register of UNIX certified product. Bad spelling or bad reading on my part. And it says down here, UNIX is a trademark and Open O logo, and the Open Group certification mark is a trademark of the Open Group. So they own the UNIX sort of trademark. So they can basically say that you can become UNIX or not. And there is some, so here for detail of certain products, you can see here, you can filter by standards. There is like the UNIX 95, there is the UNIX 98, there is the UNIX 3, which is the one that Apple is under. There is the UNIX version 7. And if you can see here, according to the people that own the trademark of UNIX, there are not a lot of operating systems that are certified UNIX or have a UNIX certification, which is really interesting when you think about it. And we have a LDAP certifications. Really, really strange. Click on the link to view products registered for each product standard. You can see this is all the standards that the C language standard, the C language V2 standard, the network file standard, the you know, these are the standards that they basically control, so what you would call it. Companies, so we have like ThinkOne, the SCO Group, SCO Group, the IBM Corporation, have HP, Apple, Apache, AT&T, Laboratories, Cambridge Limited. So it gets you a little bit of an idea about what's going on here with the Open Group. The Open Brand, so UNIX 3 certification, if you look into Apple here, product name. So this is the latest version, they registered that on silicon-based computers, also on Intel, by the way. It's registered the 9th of August, 2023. Display a copy of the brand certification. Search the common statements database for all UNIX 3 registrations. See all registered products. See more information about the UNIX 3 product standards. So this is here where they basically have licensed Apple to be called UNIX certified, not UNIX, but UNIX certified. You can see what versions here, Open Solaris was UNIX 3. We have AIX, HP UNIX. We have looked at that one. This is basically the same as this one. So what does UNIX 3 mean? The UNIX 3 product standard is a mark for system conforming to version 3 of the single UNIX specification. It is a significant enhanced version of the UNIX 98 product standard. The mandatory enhancement include alignment with the ISO/IEC number C programming language. So this version of this, or this number of the C programming language standards, the IEEE standards numbers again, and the ISO/IEC again standard number. The product standard includes the following mandatory product standard: initialization system calls and library extended version 3, commands and utilities version 4, C language version 2, initialized terminal interfaces. And you can go in here and you can see what that means for these specific licenses. So all you have to do is you have to conform to these standards, basically. And if your system or your operating system are conforming with these standards, you could be certified, get a UNIX 3 certification. That don't mean that you are UNIX. It just means that your system supports protocols within the UNIX standard. If you are UNIX, you don't need to be certified. You don't need to write or to get tested to see if you're conforming with a UNIX standard like macOS does, because you already are, because you are UNIX. What these certifications basically means is that if you are not pure UNIX, we can certify you so you are registered as a UNIX certified like system. AKA, if you know these things under UNIX, you can, the works the same on this system. We have some commonalities. There are things that work alike. You don't need to be certified if you are UNIX, because then, well, UNIX is the standard that they certify against. You know, it would be like Windows certifying itself to be Windows. You know, it would be like Linux certifying itself to be Linux. It don't have to because it is Linux. So if you see someone having a certification, like the UNIX 3 certification, that means that it's not Unix. It means that it has Unix components and it wants to be compatible with Unix enough that a lot of Unix people can work on the system, roughly speaking. If macOS was Unix, it don't need a certification. So no, macOS is not Unix. macOS just has enough in common with Unix that it can get a certification to be more Unix-like than Linux, for example. Linux don't tick these boxes. Linux has not been certified to be a Unix-like system. So theoretically, that means that Linux is way further from Unix than macOS is. But none of them are Unix. See y'all later. Bye-bye.